The definition of the high-risk diffuse large B-cell lymphoma is still unclear. There is not a consensus about how I establish the group of patients at high risk. But my definition of high risk regards conditions where the R-CHOP, that is the conventional chemoimmunotherapy for this lymphoma, is contraindicated or unfeasible, or in cases in which this combination is associated with substandard survival figures. Then we have to distinguish the high-risk patients with diffuse large B-cell lymphoma or patients with high-risk diffuse large B-cell lymphomas. In the first subgroup, the patient has some conditions that are related with a higher risk of mortality. In particular, elderly patients, frail patients, patients with some comorbidities. In this subgroup of patients, our strategy is to reduce the dose intensity of the treatment, to replace the conventional anthracyclines with liposomal doxorubicin to reduce the risk of cardiotoxicity, one of the main complications in the elderly subgroup, and to improve the efficacy of the chemoimmunotherapy using a comprehensive geriatric oncology assessment. That is a score based on comorbidity and in performance that suggests us which drugs can be avoided or in which drugs we can use a reduced dose.